UK Sailmakers presents Sail with Confidence, a series of instructional videos for both racing and cruising sailors.
On a warm day this weekend, I got a jump on servicing my boat's 8 winches. Each one gets cleaned and lubricated before the boat gets launched because winches are one of the most expensive components on a boat. Along with some non-linty rags to wipe off all the parts, this job requires grease for the gears, light machine oil for the pawls and springs, McLube one-drop oil for plastic bearings, and Neversees for stainless bolts that go into the aluminum base. As I take apart my winches, I keep groups of parts together for easy reassembly. This winch has 3 sets of gears. Make sure to wipe down all the surfaces when cleaning. Getting the spaces between the gear teeth takes time and patience. Some clean off old grease with a 1-inch wide painter's brush dipped in a solvent like mineral spirits. But since I do this annually, I can simply wipe away the grease with an old cotton t-shirt. When applying new grease, apply it to the gears sparingly. The more grease you apply, the more resistance you'll create when turning the winch. To prevent corrosion between dissimilar metals, make sure to put a product like Neversees on the stainless bolts that go into the aluminum base. Don't put winch grease on plastic needle bearings. Use a product like McLube's one-drop oil or Harkin's high-performance oil. These bearings don't need much lubrication. After you put the winch back together and you are sure that you don't have any leftover parts, give it a spin and admire your handiwork. If you do get stumped on how to reassemble the winch, know that most boat winches come in pairs so that you can study the other one. Also, winch manufacturers post diagrams on their websites. A well-cared-for winch will last for decades.